Any future that will not require a change from you will not be different from the past.
You should be more aligned.
Yes, indeed, if there's a man to pray, there's a God to answer.
The answers come for you. In the name of Jesus. Heart sets on pilgrimage. Psalm 84, verse 1 to 4. I hope we are blessed with the relationship series. Were we blessed? Do you receive understanding?
Yes.
If there's anything you still need clarity, just write it as a question. I'll respond to them. They'll send it to you. Put your numbers there. How amiable are thy tabernacles, O Lord of hosts? Play for me a song. In the presence of angels, with God's glory on their way, like the voice of many waters, I can hear the angels sing. It is a realm of your glory. It is a realm of your praise. All my desire is to sing your praise. Na na na. On pilgrimage, I want to show us tonight, as some of us return back to our homes for the break, what make people lose the flavor of Christianity on time. How can you see people hurt? Now we are in school, come to fellowship, you are hurt, you go back, everything comes back. Can't we maintain this atmosphere? For instance, we're enjoying like this. Can't this be my atmosphere 24/7? It's an issue. It was bothering me. Lord, why? You see people coming like a tornado, Lord, panting for God. And once they see a test of Him, that's all. They are off. Before you know, they begin to die. The place of satisfaction and complacency is the place of spiritual death. Why? To the searching, Psalm 40 verse 28, to the searching of his understanding, there is no end. So when you come to the place of satisfaction and complacency, you are okay with where you are in God. That's the place of spiritual death. The road to God is not a destination but a journey. Are we together? Are we together? That's what it means to have a pilgrim's heart, to continually pant after God, daily panting after Him. The Bible says, let's look at it together. My soul longeth, yea, even fainteth for the cause of the Lord. My heart and my flesh crieth out for the living God. Next verse. Yea, the sparrows have found a house, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young. Go back, please. You are too fast. You are missing me. Even thy altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Next verse. Blessed are they that dwell in the house. In thy house they will still be praising thee. Selah means pause and consider. Are we together? When you see that in scripture, it means what? Pause and what? Consider all you just finished reading. Next verse. Blessed is the man whose strength is in thee, whose heart are in the ways of them. A version, I think the NIV version said, whose heart are set on pilgrimage. Whose heart are set on pilgrimage. Those that are trying to become adventurers in God, trying to discover new things about Him every day. Are we following? The Bible says even His mercies are new every morning. There are three dimensions of God. There are three what? Dimensions of God. Number one, the God who was. The God who was. just with that information, if you live just in that dimension, you will lose so much of heaven's reality for the now. The God who what? Who works. The second dimension is the God who is. What does it mean? Daily, I am seeing realities of what he's doing that is making me say, wow, I thought I've known all about him. You are living in current realities of heaven, current revelations. Something keep you, that you are real. Every day you wake up with a kind of encounter. Every day of your life are encounters. Are we together? God manifests himself to you in ways that shows to you he's real. And then there is the dimension that is just meant for those that are crazily hungry. The God who is to come. The God where a man can live out of the now and begin to live in the future. The Bible says there are certain kind of men like that. Hebrews chapter 6. They will taste of the powers of another age. That's why when the angels see another reality of him, they begin to shout, holy, holy. The word holy is not trying to say God is holy. In the first place, he's not a sinner. When you open the Greek word there, it means a wow word. What they actually say is holy. Why? When they see a different dimension of him again, wow. They say, holy is the Lord. Who was? Who is? And then there are still about things that thing we don't know. So he's also what? To come. Are we together? Read on. Let's give me the next verse. Okay, thank you. Whose heart are set on pilgrimage? Thank you for that scriptures. Next verse, please. 6. As they pass through the valley of Baca, they make it a source of spring water. Even the autumn rain, we cover it with blessings. What it means is when we carry these kinds of heart, what we are doing is that we are creating spiritual pathways. We are digging up well in the spirit. And the Bible says, what? The autumn rain, we feel it. That's why many remain where they are in God. They get too satisfied on time. They get too filled on time. You can pray for some few healthy cases and you see them jump out of people. You say, yes, everybody, please call me an apostle. Are we following? You can worship some few moments and people say, I enjoy the way you sing. You say, yes, I sing like the angels right now. The Bible says even the angels keep shouting. There are things about the same God we yet not know. The searching of his understanding is what? Without end. See, when you live like this, what is a pilgrim? Pilgrims are those that go to Jerusalem, right? Are we together? In its real sense, they are those that go to what? Jerusalem. Why? What they saw in the Bible, they want to see it with their naked eyes. That's what it means. As long as you have not exhausted all the realities of scriptures, you are not supposed to be satisfied. Have you translated? You heard men doing that. The Bible says one time, Acts chapter 4, verse 29, 33, the apostles were being threatened and they gathered up themselves and they prayed in a room. The Bible said the place shook. Yet you say you have a prayer life. That's why I confidently tell people that I have the worst prayer life on this earth. Yet I pray 75 hours straight perfectly comfortably. The point the place shook. One time Jesus was speaking, the Bible said, and the people heard thunder, not in visions, physically. They had encounters with angelic. Peter was in prison and the angel physically took that young man who was passing through locked prison doors out and brought that guy out. How much of this reality have we tasted in our generation? And we are getting satisfied just too early. People are celebrating what is not worth celebrating. Are we together? So the pilgrims are saying, if they told us Jesus died, we are ready to any amount to go to Jerusalem and see the tomb for real. We don't want to live in philosophical information, theological knowledge and assimilations. We want to live in the reality Everything the scripture says, if the Bible says we will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover, we will cast out devils, we will heal the sick, we will raise cripples, we will raise dead people. If you are doing that, you are not permitted to satisfy, to be satisfied. The place of spirituals, of complacency and what? Satisfaction is the place of what? Spiritual death. Begin to die. You begin to die. Suddenly you find that you are still a powerful brother in the fellowship. You can preach. Everybody is falling down under the anointing. Yet you don't know what is happening to you again. Some stupid character and attitude, behavior, addictions is not taking a hold of you. Why? You are dying already. Are we following? You are dying. That's the problem. You are dying. Are we together? So I beg you, set your heart. Have this pilgrim heart. Pant for God every day. Satisfied with Him. He says, when we do this, we will make back those rivers. We will build capacity in the spirit to be filled. Are we together? So the road to God is what? Quickly. Lessons from this psalm. Let's look at five lessons we can learn. Number one. Seeking God is a journey, not a destination. Are we following? Seeking God is a journey, not a destination. So that if a man stay on that path and on that route consistently, he will soon walk the path of Enoch. We hear the Bible say he has been translated. He's found no more. Are we together? A literal human being left this earth. They didn't bury him. He walked with God. The Bible says he had this testimony. Hebrews chapter 11. He had this testimony that he walked with God. And God took him. He was no more. So if a man will stay consistently panting for God. The last time you fasted was 3 years ago. The last time you had a quality prayer life. Quality where you stayed 1 hour on your own, not fellowship. On your own to pray was 3 years ago. You are dying. You are dying. You are dying. The Bible says, when Christ, Colossians, I think chapter 2 or so, when Christ, who's alive, shall appear. So who is alive? Christ. That's what makes us survive. Our call to Christianity is a call to explore Christ and to become exactly as He is. Till the day we reach that form, we are not permitted to rest or retire. Are we together? There's so much, no matter what you think you know, there's so much to know in God. So much to know in Him. Give me, is it Job 28 verse 7? Give me that scriptures. Job 28, I'm Holy Ghost. Yes, Job 28, 7. That's it. Job 28, very quickly, please. There is a path which no fowl knoweth. There is a path. There are pathways. There are some things sometimes God do to me. I say, I didn't know this one. And which the vulture eyes had not seen. There are pathways. There are realities. There are informations. What? I did something before some of my children. And they were surprised. And I said, I can't do it in any service. If I do it, the people will run out of service. Because they will see a wizard before them. There are things God teaches us personally, we can't even teach you. Because they are not right for it. He just gives us as our personal information. Are we as our personal information? Are we following? The Bible says, give me the next verse. The lion's web have not trodden it, nor the fierce lion, even the strongest of the strongest. There are pathways they've not plumbed. If you want to last in God, maintain consistent words, hunger for Him. Are we together? Consistently. That's how you check your health spiritually. When you find out there is nothing that freaks you about God again. Young man, you need a retreat. You are dying. Are we together? Nothing freaks you. Nothing moves you. Church has become normal to you. When you come to service, you just play around. Anything, everything looks normal to you. You are dying already. You are dying. Why? You are supposed to live daily. That's what the Bible says in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 9. Apostles say, teach us how to pray. As John also taught his disciples. And he said, pray like this. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. give us this day our daily bread. How can you be asking today daily bread? Are we following? Did you catch me there? Oh, are you sure you did? Give us what? This day, our daily bread. That was what? A cry for revelation. We live by the constant revelation of God we have. That's how we survive. That's what makes us look younger. Angels look younger. They increase in strength by the ability and the access they have to what? To God's presence, including us too. The Bible says, as we behold him, 2 Corinthians 3:18, we have been changed from one level of what? Glory to another. That's what makes us look younger. We constantly read the new revelations about God. Find out you are not getting old at all. Why? For every revelation you have about him is an impartation of his DNA upon you to make you look like him in that aspect. Revelation you have about him is an impartation of his DNA upon you to make you look like him in that regard, in that aspect. Some days back, I told one, I feel like I am far away from God. I said, stop it now, Papa. I don't like to use to talk. I said, I'm very far. I know I could sense it. That's how we survive. So number two, a journey takes time and commitment. So don't feel there's one day you come and say, yes, I have reached that height in God. I have reached it now. I'm the one in top of the whole world. No, a journey takes what? Time and commitment. Also we said what? It is what? Seeking God is what? A journey. Continue till this earth is raptured, because you can't exhaust him. A man that has the whole world in the palms of his hand, how can you exhaust no anymore? Are we together? So when I say, that's why I say to be proud is stupidity. You're stupid. It's a high definition of stupidity. You don't know what you're doing. Are we together? Number three, a journey is a process, so you don't get there at an instant. A journey is what? A process. You don't get there what? At an instant. You just know God today. Ba, 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 ba. You see, that's all. You are done. Carry your Bible. Then you begin to help everybody you can. That's why you are dying. Number five, the road is not always smooth. Number four, the road is not always smooth. Let's finish up. What it takes to maintain a pilgrim's heart, this kind of heart. Then he one time asked Bishop Benson in the Wolf's house, watching one of his tape here some few days ago, God just led me to do that, and that's my bloodline. And then he asked him, he said, "The Wolf's house, what made you so hot for God consistently?" Because the norm in Christianity is that people rise today, they are hot, they are shaking. After some time, it's like they just pour water on them, they are cold again. What has sustained me consistently for 15 years is the pilgrim's heart. The desire to want to know more of him, to want to see new depths and dimensions of him. Not because I have a sermon to prepare for, that's why I go to pray. No, just to know him. Some of my children come to me, I give them the privilege to read some of my book. I have over 1,000 sermons unpreached. What did I say? 1,000. They know, ask them. I just sit down and they say, "Son, wake up, pick your pen. I want to teach you." I begin to write 1,000 sermons unpreached. So I write and just keep them for my personal information. He feeds me first. It takes a fed man to feed others. It takes a man with new life to transfer life to others. So what helps you to maintain a pilgrim's heart? Number one, genuine hunger in the spirit. Genuine hunger. Proverbs 27 verse 7. The hungry soul, every bitter thing is sweet to the hungry man. Psalm 42 verse 1. David crying as the deer panted for waters, so my soul panted for thee. Genuine hunger in the spirit. That's what will drive you to go at any length to seek God and want him, whether in times of convenience or in times of income. I was reading a story of a great servant of God I ever lived, St. Patrick of Ireland. And I read his story. I was going through it and I saw a place where he was giving one of his. I pray 100 times daily. I shouted, whether it is winter or summer, cold time or heat time, I maintained my prayers. You find me in the mountain of Ireland, pray. And that man prayed, God, a man that passed through a bush path and saw a woman crying. Say, what happened? He said, a snake just bit my child. He said, wait, entered into the bush and spoke, wherever you are, oh snake, I command you to come back. The snake returned back. And he picked the snake and said, from this day on, I bind you and your kind from Ireland. Till death, no snakes in Ireland. Put a snake there, it comes out. One man. That's a man that went to a place to preach. And the king of the place said, oh God, you are wasting time. You are speaking stories. When he's been endowed with the reality of divinity. So full of God. Are we together? And he said, if your God is truly real, wake my son, 6 months dead. Guy said, really? He said, I know whom I have stayed so much with, I've encountered. And he took his staff, which he held, and wrote on top of the grave, St. Patrick, the guy John baptized. One time they picked him, they kept him in prison, and they brought him to the day of judgment. And they say, see what they said you did. Because the people that lied against him, they've killed them. They say, see what they said you did, defend yourself. Where is your witness? He said, my Lord, if you will only give me the privilege, my witness is on the grave. Say, which privilege? I will bring him back to life for him to testify. 2 years dead. He went to the grave, commanded the man to come back to life. The man stood, testified. He said, you can die back. They brought back the man. That's a man. See, there is a way a man will gain so much upon divinity that when he comes out to the open, you will think a man is walking as though he's God. Are we together? If you can maintain hunger, the Bible speaking in Matthew chapter 5 verse 6, it said, they that thirst and hunger for righteousness shall be filled. That means hunger qualifies you for the infinite. whether of the Holy Ghost, whether of spiritual gifts, spiritual blessings, spiritual strength, spiritual graces. Hunger is the qualification for spiritual infilling. Are we together? Hunger will drive you through every kind of resistance. In Genesis chapter 30 verse 1, a hunger for a child drove the human race so much. She made a prayer. Oh God, give me a child or I die. A young man asked me, say, why, how can you stay without food 90 days and you are still alive? I said, hunger becomes the sustenance. What you are looking for becomes what gives you energy. The only time you become satisfied, you know you are not feeling the pain, is when you see what you are looking for. Are we together? It imparts a kind of energy in your spirit. It is normal to be hungry when you are fasting. What are you saying? As my body is looking like it cannot survive without food, so I am saying, Lord, without you, I can't survive. Are we together? Hunger. You don't have a right to let your hunger die. You must check it by time. The way I was hungry for God when I just gave my life to Christ, every meeting I see a poster with a title, I want to attend. I just want God. Every young brother I see, young sister, in the fellowship, because I think I'm more spiritual, I say, I want to know God. Help me. Now I have known a little of Him. God is not looking at something I was panting for again. Your pain should not kill your hunger. The Bible said they were taken into captivity in Babylon, Ezekiel. And Ezekiel chapter 1 from verse 1. He said, when I was by the river of Cheba, why the people were saying, shall we sing the long song in a strange land? The Bible says, and my eyes were opened and I began to see the visions of God. The visions of God. A man that knew how to maintain his hunger even in the place of circumstances. Even the place of terrible situations, you are still saying, Lord, I have known you are real. That's why I gave my life to you in the first place. I might not know what you are doing to my life, but I trusted you to have given you in the first place. So I choose to trust you continually. Because I know God's ways might be confusing, but His motive and intentions are always pure. Hunger because you to maintain. Alright? The pilgrim's heart. Are we together? We see the story of blind Bartimaeus in Matthew chapter 10, 46. The Bible said they were holding him down. He was shouting, oh, son of David. The Bible said the more they quiet him, the more he that's what a hungry man is. Saying the only thing that can make me quiet is when I see what I'm looking for. When I see what I'm looking for. Yesterday, I went to the bathroom. I just went in the shower because I need to attend to something. While I entered into the bathroom, God said to me, He said, son, how far? I said, Father, fine. He said, are you enjoying your breaking of your fast? I said, very well. He said, prepare. I need to be with me 60 days pray. What? I want to enjoy my life now. So when I came out of the bathroom, I dressed. One of my daughter came to check on me. I said, Father, just told me something now. He said, from 19th of this month, I don't have time again. Not holding my time anymore. He said, but rest now. I said, it was not my fault. I wish to rest. Are we together when you know what you are looking for in God? Imagine you are the one that went on a 90-day stretch fast. Will you fast for the next 10 years? The month of July, June, I was on a 60-day stretch. 60. Stretch. Are we together? Hunger drives a man through every resistance. See the woman that wanted her daughter to be healed, the Syrophoenician woman. Say, Master, help my child. She's vexed with a devil. See, hunger is a purchasing power in the spiritual realm. It will buy anything for you. The Bible speaking in Luke chapter 18, verse 1, is a scripture I try to explain. Should I show you something there? Give me a minute. Let me show you hunger. Give me Luke 18, verse 1. Just look up. Tell them a parable that men always to pray and not to offend. Next verse. Was the just one town who didn't fear God and respect man. Next verse. He though in that town kept coming to him, saying, give me justice. She kept what? Coming to him. Next verse. Now, what we read, the Bible said that judge is what? unrighteous. Are we following? So it means that man doesn't what? Know God. Don't forget that fact. For a while he was unwilling, but later he said to himself, did you even see the proof? He said, even though I don't fear God or man. Next verse. Yet because of this widow keep pestering me, I will give her justice. So sometimes it means it might not necessarily even be because of your righteousness, but your hunger can pull certain realities from the heavens. He said, I don't fear God or man. It's not a basis of righteousness here. Just because of what? The persistence. Are we together? Are we following? Number two. Hunger. Stay hungry for him as a sign of spiritual health. Consistent fellowship in prayers, fasting, and with the word. Consistent fellowship in prayers, fasting, and with the word. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. The Bible says, they that wait upon the Lord shall what? Renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not faint. They shall walk and not be weary. Are we together? That scripture over and over again. It will help you to keep in tune with the Holy Ghost. Consistent fellowship. Give me 1 Timothy 4, verse 7. 1 Timothy 4, 7. Sheila, Baba, praying the Holy Ghost everywhere. The Bible says, but hold on. But refuse profane and old wives' what? Fables. And exercise thyself rather unto what? Godliness. What is godliness? Shall I show you? Give me 1 Timothy, Holy Spirit. Is it 1st or 2nd? Give me 1 Timothy 3. Let me see something there first. Holy Ghost. But exercise. That means for we to be godly, we need to what? Exercise ourselves. Good. The Bible says, and without controversy, great is the mystery of what? Godliness. What is godly? Godliness does not mean holiness. No. This is the definition I want to show you now. That God was made manifest in a human flesh. So what is religion? Man trying to be like God. What is godliness? God living naturally through a man. How can that be? But rather, exercise thyself unto what? Godliness, where divinity can sit upon a mortal flesh. Divinity can sit upon a mortal flesh. Are we together? Rather, exercise yourself. Exercise. Keep doing that till you transform your mortal being to become immortal. Knowing fully well that a man that is locked up in the mortal realm cannot be summoned by mortality. One of my papa in the faith, Apostle John Suleiman, he was passing through Benin, and the armed robber stopped the car. He refused to stop, and they sprayed him 14 bullets. They were jumping out of his body. One time, a lady came and poured him acid. He took his handkerchief and cleaned the face, threw it on the ground. The handkerchief was jumping out. I read the story of our great father in the faith, Umar Pa. The Bible says, the history has it, that one time he was just going, and the armed robber stopped him, and he said, come down from your car. He came down, they said, give us money. He said, I have no money to give you. And they took the fuel of his car and they said, take to drink. You are dead today. And he took it. He said, Lord, thank you for this water. And he drank. He said, do you care for? Those are men that cannot be affected by mortality. How? They were exercising themselves rather unto what? Godliness. Subjecting themselves to continual fellowship. Do you know there is a way you walk so close to somebody, you start looking like the person? Check when people marry, they say they start resembling each other. That's how it is when you stay with God. Very quickly, you start looking like him. 2 Corinthians 13. As we behold him, we are changed. We are changed. Suddenly, you just find certain things that cannot happen to you again. You just wondering, what is happening to my body? You see the testimony of the young man? Just speaking words over them and oil is gushing out of his hands. It's gushing out. Are we together? Exercise. So consistent fellowship in prayers, in fastings, with the word, reading Christian literature, watching things that will spur up your hunger, spur up your spirit, looking at certain things God is doing, and you say, wow. One time I watched the broadcast of a man of God, a man I respect so much, and he's a man that has taught reality in the kingdom. Jesus, so much reality. And he stood right in the front of a meeting trying to prove one verse of the Bible, 1 Peter 1 and verse 10. And of this salvation, the saint of old inquired diligently, trying to know, and he was discerning that salvation. And he was trying to prove. The Bible says, and the glory that should follow after the death of Christ. And he stood, he said, you don't know what you have. He said, let me show you the power in Christianity is so much. If you are dark here, become fair. People turn in fair, my friend. If you are fair, become dark. If you are ugly, look more handsome. I will see it real with my very eyes. I shouted, Jesus. Jesus. So you see, subjecting myself to that, what? Spurring my, it was keeping me at a state to know that there is more in God. There's more. There's more in God. When you don't have what challenges you, you remain where you are for a very long time. That's why you must subject your life, surround yourself with inspirators and motivators. Watch things that will spur up your hunger for God. If not, you will remain at that state for a very, very long time. A very long time. Now, the broadcast one, sometimes I have them enough, over 2,000 of the supernatural on my phone, on my system. And I was watching one about Melbourne. I like telling the story so much. He broke into an encounter with God. Was praying for a crippled man. The man with one leg, I was seeing it with my very eyes, and one shoe, and prayed for the other leg came out with the other shoe. Then I prayed for some few cases, and people say, praise the Lord, I'm healed. Then I'm jumping. To be proud is absolute stupidity. Are we together? So much in God, so much reality in God. So much. One time I just wanted to prove something to my children, and I said, let me show you some things I have still chosen not to do. And the girls stayed in my house. We worship. I think he was around. We worship. I just wanted to prove a point. I said, get me a key. And they brought the key to me, and I held the key, and I said, metal begin to bend, and the metal was bending instantly. They shouted, Jesus. I said, there are things we know we can't still do now. Are we following? We can't. One of my sons came one time to my office, and he was complaining. He said, my battery is low. I said, give me your phone. And I give him back 100%. There are reality. The place of satisfaction and complacency is the place of spiritual death. You are dead. Number three.
I love your praise.
Number three, lifestyle of purity. Strive to maintain a lifestyle of purity. Anything that suffocates your conscience drives you away from God. Anything that keeps you in guilt drives you faster away from God. It makes you find it difficult to approach His presence. Strive for what? Purity. The Bible says, for thou art worthy to receive all glory and honor. Are we following? For you are fearful in praises. You are doing wonders. You are glorious in what? Holiness. So if you want to see glory, maintain purity. The greater your purity, the greater the glory. I think Psalm 45 or 6 or so, he said, the scepter of this kingdom is a scepter of righteousness. That's on what the authority of this kingdom sits. Righteousness. You can be saying, I'm still doing some wrong things. I'm still living in impurity. And I'm still casting some few sick people. I'm still seeing visions and prophesying. Now ask yourself, if you are not living in purity, how much of it will you have seen? You are being cheap and wrong. If you are in impurity and you are enjoying such a level, what if you decide to live in purity? You ask yourself. Glorious in holiness. So what does it mean? The devil is frustrated in holiness. Frustrated. That's why they are called unclean spirits. Nothing frustrates the devil like a depth of purity. If you are a young Christian, a young minister, If you can maintain a height of purity, you have divine power and energy gushing out through your mortal bodies. Gushing out. Why? You can transmit life to others. I don't struggle to pray for a smoker. Why? Because I don't smoke. Are we together? I have never had it once and up to smoke. So it means there is something around my life or in my life that makes me not to smoke. So when I see a smoker, I transfer it to him. Naturally, you can't smoke again. I don't pray or fast over their head. Are we together? That glory that makes me. Just give them and tell them, inhale it. It's the same glory that kissed me. Inhale it too. And the person is struggling to smoke now. Maintain purity. Finally, brokenness of heart. Psalm 51 verse 17. A contrite and broken spirit, the Lord says he will not despise. Brokenness of heart. A broken and a contrite heart. Maintain it. What is a broken heart? A heart that knows how to melt before God. What is a contrite heart? A heart that knows how to repent very fast. Who tells you I don't miss it very much? Plenty of it. When it happens, I say, Lord, you know if I run to the devil now, you will call me a suspect. I still choose to follow you. One time, one of my child called me, say, Papa, please help me. You can't follow God consistently for 15 years like this. What is the secret of your consistency? Laughed because I knew what she was waiting for. See, my prayer and fasting life. The way I study. I said, daughter, the secret of my consistency is that I keep falling. But anytime I fall, I get where I am. I say, Lord, you know, you are doing that I can beat me, but I am following you. So I fall many times. I'm not the minister that will come and tell you lie. Are we together? Was it yesterday or this morning? I told her of my daughter. I said, I'm tired. I don't feel like going to church. See, Jesus. Yes. You think it's only people too that don't use the feet to come to church? I was doing them so that we understand that the best of a man is still with her. I said, I don't feel like coming to church. There are times I wake up, I don't feel like doing devotion. Hey, Abba. Every day. However, we say, oh God, if you don't keep helping me, I'm finished. A broken and a contrite heart. Finally, for tonight, right association. Change any attention that kills your hunger for God. Association can either strengthen your hunger for him or kill your hunger. Psalm 13 verse 20. Walk with the wise, you'll become wise. Proverbs 27 verse 17. Are we following? Say, so the a brother sharpened the countenance of his brother. Psalm 1 verse 1 to 3. That walketh in the counsel of the ungodly, not standeth in the way of sinner. Are we together? Certain people and things have fire extinguishers. Are we following? They are not teaching you to go and steal, but they will make you not too hungry for God again. You find out that certain people that come close to your life, suddenly you don't. Church is not something that freaks you anymore. You don't just feel normal. You are okay. You are normal. Separate yourself from them. Are we following? Don't say I was trying to save them. I want to gather them around my life to save them. No. Christianity is you first. What it means is that you can't try to save others and lose your own salvation. We following. That's what Paul did. 1 Corinthians 9 verse 24. He said, Lord, I won't preach to others. Me, myself, should not be what? Be cast away. Don't in your bid of saving, you are the president of your fellowship, the sister called mama, or whatever you call yourself. Whatever post, you are saving everybody. You can't do devotion again. You can't do this one. My dear, they won't celebrate you in hell. You better walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Rise up to your feet.
I love to praise your name. We bless your name, sweet Jesus.
Love to praise
your name.
I love.
Lord, thank you for your blood shed for us. Thank you for your body broken for our sake. Please open the bread very quickly. Please open it for me. Thank you for your body broken for us. Thank you for your blood, oh God, shed for our sake. May this communion tonight communicate you in entirety into us, oh God. Let every dying altar come alive. Let every dead zeal, dead devotion come alive. Let everything that is dead in your life receive the life of Jesus tonight. Shikabarate kabosana maya galagadash. Let your life be communicated to us. Let the sick be healed. Let your prayers be set free. Let the afflicted be delivered tonight. Let there be mighty miracles from the communion tonight. I communicate your life to your people. Thank God for the miracles recorded thus far. I pray for an explosion of miracles tonight. I hear the communion communicate and encounter to your people. Let their eyes be opened. Let their understanding be opened. Let your life in them come alive. Thank you, our Father, in Jesus' name. Lift up your hands, everybody. May every of your moments be the very atmosphere of heaven. May you be known as men and women that are custodian of divine presence. Everywhere you go from today, may people see Jesus in your life. I decree and declare Christ in the eyes of everyone that will see you. Christ in the ears of everyone that will hear of you. Christ in the ears of everyone that will hear the words speak. Christ in the heart of everyone that will think about you. Christ in your going out, Christ in your coming in. Christ when you sleep, Christ when you are awake. In all you do, in all that concerns your life, let the visible presence and atmosphere of Christ be seen upon it. In the name of Jesus. Speak, you will not suffer loss. You will not show no shame. For those of you going home, I decree safety to your those of you still around, may this moment also be a time of encounters for you. May you meet God in a way you have never met him before. Your hands will not know this. I provoke financial daily record of financial miracles. Money you don't expect come your way. In the name of Jesus. Every due expectation. The Bible says hope deferred maketh the heart sick. Every long-standing prayer request. I call for the attention and intervention of heaven upon it right now. In the name of Jesus. I hear in my spirit some of you said, let me come tonight to Grace Friend and conclude my exam with God. The grace of excellence that rests on us and upon our life, may it speak for you. Questions you didn't answer correctly, I ask, let the angels of God go right now and correct them for you. In the name of Jesus. Questions you didn't finish, let the angels of God go right now and finish them up for you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every cause you are scared of, every cause that is shaking your face, I stand as a voice to the nation to decree tonight. I give you ease in them. In the name of Jesus. I decree supernatural increase to CGPAs. Supernatural increase. Supernatural increase. Supernatural increase. Supernatural increase. In the name of Jesus. I hear in my spirit, hear this, I see a miracle. I hear in my spirit somebody saying, I want to graduate with a 2-1. But what I am on right now is a 2-2 and it looks impossible. I stand under God confidently to say to you, I've watched your certificate. What is written upon it is a 2-1. If you are that person, I release it to you. In the name of Jesus. Wherever you are having one kind of outstanding or the other, as here and there, bad grades, I command them to supernaturally change. I command those S to supernaturally disappear. I change them to A's and B's. In the name of Jesus. I pray for the final year bread in this house tonight. For the fact you came for this meeting tonight and you participated in this communion, hear my voice. Nothing keeps you in FUT longer than this graduation. Any cause that you will have kept you, I waved it from this place supernaturally. In the name of Jesus. I decree and declare, every decision that will be taken, every policy that will be taken, must work for your good and favor. In the name of Jesus. As a priest over this house, over your exams, 100 level student, other levels, I give you my blessings. I speak God's favor upon it. He will have a reason to smile. You will not weep over your result. May mercy speak for you. May mercy speak for you. May favor speak for you. May God's grace shine upon your result. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for our Father. Just wave to him and celebrate him. Give him praise. Thank you for a miracle. I see miracles everywhere. Everywhere. I see somebody, there is a course you are scared of, and they said you need to go and sort the lecturer in one way or the other. I pray for you. It is over. You don't need to go. You can't fail that course. God's hands is upon you. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord bless you. In Jesus' name.
Thank you for listening. We trust that you have been blessed.